Good afternoon. Welcome to the fourth session of the second day of the conference on narrativizing indigeneity. It's a pleasure to begin this very interesting session, Challenges of Community Radio, on the subject of community radio and its role in the emancipation of the disadvantaged sections of society especially. It's a pleasure to invite Dr. Sridhar, Dr. R. Sridhar, please come and join us. The other panelists, Mr. Mamoon Abdul Qayyum, welcome. Mr. M. Suresh, are you here? Mr. Mahendra Kumar Padi, are you here? Okay, two out of four. So without much ado, Dr. Sridhar is going to lead the session with a PowerPoint presentation on the subject of challenges of community radio and tribal development in India. And I propose the panelists do the presentations and we will open the session to audience participation thereafter.
Thank you very much, and thank you very much for the chair, and also Dr. Patnaik for inviting me here, all the way from Delhi. I really didn't expect that I had to present it today. I thought it was tomorrow. Everybody's saying that, so I want to repeat it. But anyhow, yesterday when evening I contacted Dr. Chandrabanu Patnaik. He said you have to present it at 3:45. So I could make some presentation. I'm glad that, Dr. Vinod Agarwal is here, so I'll have to be very careful. I just now told him in the lunch, whatever I'm going to talk is only his thoughts, which originated 30, 35 years back, and his way, his dreams, and I would have done about 0.1% of fulfilled his dreams, you know, their work dreams. Therefore, if any mistakes are there, he is there to correct me. Whatever is there, it's Dr. Vinod Agarwal. Okay. Community radio and tribal development. Actually, when you see the Government of India's community radio policy of 2002 and later modified into 2006, the word tribal development doesn't appear in the policy. Even though all the other highlights of this policy, which is a very small radio station with 50 watts power, 15 kilometers radius, is best suited for the tribal hamlets, tribal villages in the country, rather than in Chennai or Delhi or Bombay. Delhi and NCR region has got 18 radio stations. I don't know how they got the frequencies. But I'm also part of the game, but to suggest how to go about the rules. But anyhow, then I was doing a research. Now we have got 188 radio stations in the country. Even though the first radio station was started in 2004, as part of the India Shining campaign of the NDA government. Of course, I was the culprit to start that. Then we said we'll have 4,000 radio stations in 1 year. Today, Dr. Agarwal was just telling me in the lunchtime that the Government of India is forming another committee in 2016 to see that there will be 4,000 radio stations by 2017. So that, okay. I just come to this, my brief, because I have got time, 10 minutes, 15 minutes he has given me, I'll finish it in 15 minutes. Because I'm basically a radio person. So, therefore, 2004 and 2015, the stand has not taken place, and we have 187 stations, and the community radio activists are all talking that it is all in, majority of them are educational institutions, including the one set up by Dr. Vinod Agarwal. And one set up by me. But there are 80 radio stations which are in the educational institutions, 30 in the agriculture sector, 60 in the NGO sector. But the government has already given 500 letters of intent, out of which 350 are the NGO sector, they are unable to start the radio station. Because on the one hand, the NGOs want to criticize the government. Every action of the government has to be criticized by the civil society. And for that, they want the government to fund the radio station. So that's the only thing, because these NGOs are not able to even find a little about 5 lakhs, 6 lakhs rupees, muster the money from the community, crowdfunding it, they could not start the radio station. So they are all waiting for government and it's going on. So let me come. Page down. Okay, make it. Page down, okay. So I've already talked about the India history of the community radio policy. And then it, even before that, Dr. Bhagat, Vinod Agarwal was there for the educational radio stations of India. At the time we had the Kargil war, we had the parliament attack, and the government wanted to privatize radio. And then they gave it to IGNU, that failed. And then secondly, then they gave it to community radio, to educational institutions. Then they revised it to give it to NGOs and agriculture sector. And examples of, I want to give you some examples of, next slide. Suddenly I found, because of Dr. Patnaik, I was able to go through these 187 stations and analyze where are these things. A very strange example of Vanya, which is in Madhya Pradesh, is a tribal government enterprise, public sector enterprise. They applied for a radio station. The activists who were in the committee, screening committee, did not like it to be given to them. And the secretary was from Madhya Pradesh cadre. So how to get them the radio station? So they came to me and said, sir, wherever there's a radio tribal school, you apply in the name of tribal school and then get the license and then you could do programs for tribals. Unfortunately, Madhya Pradesh has got 10 Vanya radio stations in tribal places. I have not heard of a single good success story for the past 5 years from Madhya Pradesh. This is run by Vanya. There are other stations also in Madhya Pradesh. I'll come to that one. Okay, that's one. Then, it is all the controversial things. There is, okay, Wayanadu Welfare Society is situated in Wayanadu in Kerala. And that's one of the richest community radio stations in the country, having a 2 crore income per year. Because that guy, in the name of tribal development, set up a radio station in the hills, which covers half the Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu. Even a small mosquito transmitter, I call it, is a mosquito transmitter of 50 watts, covers half the Kerala, and he gets so much of advertisement revenue, nothing is done for tribal development, except only one program, I'll come to that later. Okay. And then they broadcast film songs, they broadcast advertisements, all in the name of tribal development. Okay. Then we have a Radio Brahmaputra Assam. I see only the programs in the Google. Okay. I don't see the programs in anywhere. They know how to advertise even one small water not coming. And the Sarpanch was, they said we'll announce it in the radio and the Sarpanch got very much upset. So he got the water. That's the only story I heard about Radio Brahmaputra. Brahmaputra, water is not a problem. Then Radio Dimsa Koraput, I'll come to that about Orissa. And then there are another 4 radio stations in Orissa. Has anybody heard of a community radio station in a tribal area in Orissa? Tribal, 5 are there. You would have heard of Radio Namaskar, Radio Namaskar in Konarak, or you would have heard about Shiksha Anusandhan University in that SCA. But you have not heard of it. There are 5 stations in Orissa for the past 3 years functioning. What is the name of that? I am coming to that. I am coming about it. Okay. And there is one radio station in Gujarat. I don't know, Dr. Agarwal knows about it. Sir, it's very well documented in the Google. Radio Aikar. There's a radio station, only one radio station other than Brahmaputra, Gyan Taranga. This is run by the Open University in Assam. There was the first radio station in the entire Northeast. And unfortunately, you see the photographs, all are students and teachers and guitars and sitars, no tribal instruments. Then we have got one good example of Radio Dhadkan, which is in Shivpuri, Madhya Pradesh. And then I will also talk about Radio Kothagiri, Tamil Nadu, which is doing for the Nilgiri tribes. I will also finally touch one of my famous subjects, that what is the easier thing to do, even though Vinod Agarwal's wish should come dream, that 4,000 radio stations should come in next year. If not, and if I don't get that 5 lakhs or 6 lakhs of rupees to start a radio station, how can I start a radio station without the government license today, this moment, and I can reach the world? There must be some expenditure. There's no free meals in the country, in the world, so we can do that. I'll come to that later. How it can help the tribal society, I want to talk to you. Radio Matoli, which I said is, Matoli means echo. They have got a program called Unarvu, it's called Awakening. It's the only program which is done by the Wayanadu Social Service Society in Kerala. And it has become a mouthpiece of the government of Kerala. And the only photograph they give you in the website is not the tribal holding the microphone like this, but people doing farm work. Radio Kothagiri, they got everything free from government because of one joint secretary was the former collector of Nilgiris. So she came and they got everything free. And it's the very richest keystone NGO, is the richest NGO. By they are selling all these herbs and all sorts of things. Everything was given free by BESIL in as corporate social responsibility. Fortunately, they do only 1 hour program per day or 2 hours program per day. And both the 2 hours are done by the tribals. The only comfort is, and even the station director, manager, is the tribal. Because she became a station manager, a foreigner came and married her. That's a different question. But it's really run by the tribals of Nilgiris. And yes, everything came free, so the keystone has no access to grind. So they do a 2 hour program. This is a face of Radio Dhadkan, where she says, Rambati, a tribal woman from the Sakaria tribe of Madhya Pradesh, and she has become very famous in that place. Here comes a Dhadkan radio woman. And she walks 5 kilometers every day and then do this recording. So one small example I was able to pick up from the compendium of the Government of India that Radio Dhadkan is doing. Unfortunately, this is run by an eye doctor, this NGO. Koraput, I got that Dimsa community, the first and only community in the southern part of Odisha. This is done by the UNICEF. UNICEF is funding this radio station. And mostly for that, what's it called, that the UN's 10, what is it, sir? Millennium Development Goals. By 2015, they said, now they made it 2020. That goal scale, UNICEF is funding. It is only those things. It's not very friendly towards the tribals, not empowering them, just giving information to them. These are the stations I heard this morning from Radio Namaskar person. Radio Swayam Sakti Karya, that's what somebody was saying, no? You are talking. Radio Muskan Pulbani. Muskan, I don't know. I heard they are broadcasting 24 hour film songs. Okay. Radio Surabhi Dasballa. And Radio Namaskar Konarak. I understand the central government minister for tribal welfare. He is from Orissa, and then he wants Radio Namaskar to do programs. He belongs to Konarak, I suppose. And the Konarak is yet to decide. No, no, there are some pockets here and there. And he says, I can give you money, you don't do the program. He is not willing to do the program. And I heard that Dr. Chandrabhanu Patnaik recently went to Konarak and the radio station was locked on key. And so, we don't know. He just went there recently to go to. Then they do broadcast something at some time as and when they please. There's no monitoring, so they can do anything. If there's a Konarak festival, the money is coming, they will do that. I know him, he's a very good friend, so everybody takes my criticism very well. Okay, Radio Aikar Gujarat is broadcasting through All India Radio, I suppose. They are ready to get a license, 30 minutes per week. Yan Taranga Assam, they are supposed to serve the communities in this poor Hatigan, Lokra, Kanapara, etc. Assamese, Nepalese, Karbi, Raba, Hindi speaking communities. They are supposed to serve. Okay, can I get this? Wait, let us go back. Next slide. Next slide, I'm finishing it. There is a very, very beautiful initiative in Chhattisgarh, which has got an international prize. International prize. But my personal view is that it's a very simple technology. Is the most publicized, most documented effort, but we don't know the exact outlook, output or impact on this. But it is getting continuously awards. It's only mobile phone, just give some messages, and then people will dial one for this, dial two for fisheries, dial three for animal husbandry, dial four for agriculture. But that's one. Okay, now can I go to that site? Previous slide. Can you go to that? Is it coming? No. So now my proposal suggestion, which is being implemented by 24 of the organization in the country. Everybody will say internet radio is free. Just go, register yourself on a site, give your username, password. Patnaik Radio is on air or Agarwal's Radio is on air within 5 minutes. And you speak, ring somebody in, Sunita Williams in the sky, and she will hear, okay, Patnaik, I heard your voice. So we say we are broadcasting globally. Yes, anybody can talk. You can pick up anybody in America or Australia and then they will immediately listen. Yes, I am broadcasting and they are listening. That's not the way. Actually, there's a lot of problems. You know, the YouTube, the browsing, bandwidth, etc. So, some indigenous, made in India, the efforts are going on. So what we say is, do not go and buy computers, do not buy software, do not engage IT people. If you are an NGO, have some good people to serve. Just hire, like I take a phone, put a SIM of Airtel or Vodafone. I'm not happy with Airtel, throw it out, go to Vodafone, I'm not there. go to Idea or go to BSNL. Similarly, book persons who are having bandwidth. In the international scenario, it will be Amazon or Google or Microsoft. Or Indian scenario, some people will be there. Just take that particular portion so that even 10 people, 100 people, 1,000 people can listen at the same time. Than worrying about buying a computer, then there will be corruption. And then within 1 year, the computer has to be upgraded. The software will get corrupt, software has to be upgraded. Nothing is needed. All that I need is an internet connection. I have the mic, I have the laptop, and I can do the broadcast. Or I can use 3G, 4G connection with the phone, and it's available to you on the as an app in your Android phone or a Microsoft phone, not iPhone. It's an app. Now people will say India doesn't have, I think Chandrababu Patnaik also told me that in Borissa we don't have that the smartphones, is it? The telecom people say 60% of Indian phones are smartphones. All are smart. Now today, you know the whole thing is going on 251 rupees smartphone. Ringing bells. Therefore, smartphones prices have come down like anything. And even our poorest of poor people prepared to pay 99 rupees for a data and to download some songs, stream some songs. Or they also do the Bluetooth technology to transfer to rickshawalas changing their songs by Bluetooth. Therefore, we should now think of the future, and then with an app, free app, they can listen, and streaming is cheaper, much, much cheaper than downloading. One downloading of a signature tune, what is that, ringing tone, costs 15 rupees, 30 rupees, 40 rupees. One song they want to download is 30 rupees, but if you do a streaming audio, it doesn't cost much. Cost is equal to WhatsApp. There's a very small, famous saying there that somebody went and paid something to Puri beggar, some 10 rupees, and he wanted to click a photograph, some foreigner. And that fellow said, okay, thank you, sir, send it to me on WhatsApp. So WhatsApp has become so famous today. Therefore, the same cost will be for streaming, so that's why I say no need to go to government, no need to get licenses, just sit down here, plan your programs, have the community, give the mic, you are there. So that's why I think Centurion University has also tried last time, a few weeks back, when the Minister for Skills Development came to Boating, they tried it, and I hope that can become a trendsetter in the thing. And also he was telling about that he wants to have a tribal folk music channel. So we can have any number of channels without worrying for caste, without worrying for anything. That's all I want to say. I hope the community radio movement will take off, and then they are all saying that they are going to listen to it in a small radio set. I have done surveys in 11 places now, 11,000 people recently. Nobody knows the younger generation the name of a radio. They know the word FM, and they know the word FM as an icon in the phone, and they have not seen a radio set. Therefore, the name of radio has changed, so we have to make it community media or community audio. And that's the only way that we can do it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Sridhar. Sir, just a quick comment. The presentation was, you know, very comprehensive and illuminating. One of the things that we always talk about in media is that content is king. Would you comment on the quality of training and teaching that we have available to develop strong content makers, people who have the capacity to competently curate a show that is appropriate and meaningful? While on the hardware side, you know, it's become simpler as technology advances, but content remains still fluid.
Personally, I feel that there are not very, very few content makers. The example of Sight in 1975, where they did a lot of research and produced interactive participatory content. Today, if you go and see any radio station, private, commercial, or community, we'll have to cry. Nothing is borrowed content. There are no radio professionals for radio. Either they come from advertisement field or television or newspapers. So there are no radio personnel, except All India Radio type of government yes man type. Then community radio, there are no models and there are no training facilities. There are no decus and there are no organizations which is prepared to give participatory, interactive, community-based content. So that's a very, very bad thing, is very bad. There are NGOs who can think of interactivity and participatory, but they cannot create interesting audio programs.
So as a follow-up, what concerns me is that people who are significant actors in this area of work and practice, are there avenues of advocacy and avenues of capacity building or policy influencing that can lead to development of rigorous content making criteria, or is it all stagnant?
Madam, there are policy. There are so many people in the country who are talking about community radio policy. Radio policy or digital radio, anything. There are activists who talk about it. Okay, news should be there, that should be there, this should be there. But there are no training institutions.
That's important.
No training institutions.
Yeah, it's zero, yeah.
We need training institutions.
I think that's really critical gap to be filled. Any questions? Yes, please, go ahead.
Sir, you were there in the inaugural of Jamia Radio. So later what we have experienced there, that to run the Soj, when we are going to call some experts or other known people to arrange the talk Soj, when we are going to call some experts, that time they need some remuneration and they charge. And in case of government universities, it is difficult to provide them the remuneration and all those things to bring them to the talk Soj. So in that case, what is the solution actually?
See, there's an All India Radio model. You go, Vice Chancellor goes, he will get 2,000 rupees. A professor goes, he gets 1,000 rupees per talk. There's an All India Radio model. The community radio model is only voluntarism. There is no voluntarism in India today. Okay. If Jamia Millia is a failure because, shall I tell you, I gave a project to them from some ministry. We did a survey, and then when the project was given, the project investigator, PI and the coordinator came to me, sir, what will I get? We said, please give some money to the community, not 500 rupees, just come the 100 rupees, give them chai, give them biscuits, give them 50 rupees, 100 rupees. We made some provision for the community to be, because he leaves the job of ironing or just, yeah. He comes, so give them 100 rupees. So what will I get? So we said, you won't get anything. So they returned the money. So this is the, and Jamia is supposed to train excellent media people in the country. So the attitude has to change.
My name is Dinesh. I have a little bit of background with community radio. We are a small group. We even published a site called communityradio.technology, which lets you compare, which lets you see all the community radios in India and even see whether you can apply for a new station at some point and compare policies of community radio across the world. My question is, if you look at the history of community radio, that was when the receiver was really cheap and the transmitter was expensive. Now, with everybody having a phone in a pocket where it's a receiver and a transmitter, right? And using, and an obvious outcome of a community radio there is a WhatsApp. Are you on any WhatsApp groups, sir?
I'm in so many WhatsApp groups.
Yeah. So each one is a community radio, right? You broadcast to your group and they receive it, right? And they broadcast and you receive it. So it's changed not only the one-way transmission, but also made it a broadcast receiver kind of thing. And allowing you, you don't even have to do what you said. Go do this and you know, cloud something and all that. You just start a WhatsApp group, right? But my question is, can you compare that with the role or significance of a community radio for a group in today's scenario, right? Where you want community radio in a traditional sense and compare it to WhatsApp group and see like where we have the beauty of that versus the beauty of this.
I'll give you a practical example. In the year 2000 to 2005, we had Yahoo videos. All of us loaded video programs in Yahoo. Today it's gone. Okay. Now we had YouTube. It's all, everybody was putting trash on it. Everything was there. Today every YouTube video starts with a 5 seconds ad skip ad. Okay. Then about a few years back, there was a radio called shoutcast.com. I think you must have known about it. And then all the open source people, activists are all saying that open source, Linux, and then the shoutcast.com. So everybody put it in shoutcast.com. Today, shoutcast.com gives you only 10 listeners. The 11th listener, you pay $40. So WhatsApp was 55 rupees 1 year back. Today, it's free. Tomorrow, they may charge you. YouTube, there is a ad-free chargeable channel. And then all sorts of low resolution, high resolution. Therefore, it's better to have something which we pay and demand. WhatsApp group, today it's good. You can have about 256 people in a WhatsApp group. You can have a radio broadcaster, nothing wrong. I am also suggesting that. But when you want to reach 10,000 people, everybody is... So I do not believe in taking anything free. Today they offer, you see, SMS came free, then it charged. Email was free, today everybody says email free, you know how much spams come, and also the moment I say I am going to Borisa for another 10 days, the moment I check makemytrip.com for the ticket, then for 15 days I am being flooded with it. That means, therefore I believe today WhatsApp you can try, but we should also have something permanent. That's my belief. And the cost comes down. When the FM radio, I was the first person to interview somebody in 1976 when the first FM radio was introduced in India, in Chennai. Nobody knew it. Up to 1992, there are about 6 or 7 FM stations in the country, Delhi, Bombay. You know, Agarwal would have done research. And the All India Radio people are all saying, FM radio is very costly, sir. 1,000 rupees, say, 2-in-1, only people who are coming from Malaysia, Singapore are bringing this. Therefore, we don't want to give good programs on FM. So FM was wasted for 20 years in India. The day we privatized it, one day, I was the person who privatized it. Times of India, we gave 9 hours. Next day, AM to PM on Times FM. Radio never sounded before. He started marketing that FM. And then FM radio came to 30 rupees, sir. By 1995-96, we had a Chinese radio set, small set for 30 rupees. Today, the digital radio costs 1,000 rupees. So India, nobody should go to digital radio.
I'd like to invite Dr. Mamun Abdul Qayyum from Bangladesh, all the way from Bangladesh, to give a presentation on the role of community radio as alternative media for indigenous issues, a case study on indigenous peoples of northwestern Bangladesh. Take it away, Mamun.
At last session, we learned a lot about Indian community radio and role on community radio on tribal affairs. My session is about role of community radio on indigenous issues as alternative media in Bangladesh. It's my special pleasure to be here, Honorable Moderator, respected key presenter, scholars and all, and organizers. Have a lovely day. I am MD Mamun Abdul Qayyum from University of Rajshahi, Bangladesh. I am faculty of the department, and I am not part of community radio, due to student of mass communication and journalism, I had to learn about the media. And my presentation is about the role of community radio, the role of community radio as alternative media for indigenous issues, a study on indigenous people of northwestern Bangladesh. As I am describing here, as community radio, there are, in Bangladesh at present there are 17 community radio, and it started its journey in 2011, and now it is. I just want to add here some that I just analyze some content here of Radio Podda, which is situated in northwestern part of Bangladesh in Rajshahi. There are some reasons because of I have analyzed the event of Community Radio Podda, because it launched its journey in first time as community radio in Bangladesh. State of indigenous people in Bangladesh, as we learn that there is around 370 million peoples, indigenous peoples in the world, and there are around 1.8% people in Bangladesh, indigenous people in Bangladesh who are living there. We can consider them as marginalized, deprived, and they are struggling in everyday's life for survival in Bangladesh. And there are 45 recognized indigenous communities in Bangladesh, though they demand them as Adivasi, indigenous people, but recently Bangladesh government has proposed a bill that signs that they are not indigenous people, but they are considered as small community or minority people in Bangladesh. Why this is a topic of discussion, indigenous people and media? We know that in traditional media, as newspaper or traditional radio or in television, and most of this media considered indigenous people as very ethnic community, and they can't cover them much because of their city-centered characteristics, because of their pressure on press, because of their political affiliation, because of their affairs with trade like this, because this is very development item, ethnic minority or ethnic community, these are very development item, and most of the media can't consider this as a development item, most of the traditional media. So this is a matter of community radio and stereotype coverage of ethnic minority in mainstream media. A few research on indigenous people and the media conducted. There are lack of research in Bangladesh affiliated with the media and indigenous people in Bangladesh. Why community radio emerges in Bangladesh? Because of scope for voiceless, as from Bolivia. We know that from Bolivia it was launched first time in the world, and then and we can consider Sri Lanka, Australia, New Zealand, Latin America, Africa, and to your country, to my country. It was launched in, and I told earlier, in 2011. And I just here some, given some research data that in Bangladesh, political affairs and political affairs news is very prominent in media, and city-centered in very prominent in media. Lack of public interest in traditional media and pressure on press, prominence of city news is always a challenge for mainstream media. Why community radio emerges in Bangladesh? Because of it provides guarantees to access to information among the village or grassroots people, and free expression and increase community participation and ensure democracy and governance. We know that these are linked with indigenous community people in Bangladesh as well as all over the world, to protect the rights, as they are marginalized, they are deprived from their rights. They are always this media can protect their rights, facilitate the poverty alleviation and process, because as we all know that most of the indigenous community in Bangladesh are below under poverty, and secure our people's interest with then active participation. These are the reasons of and then facilitate rural development and agricultural promotion. Women empowerment and promote gender sensitivity, ensure local level good governance and accountability, disaster and crisis management, social progress and curbing injustice in the society, protect and promote local and community culture and traditions. This is very important for the media as well as community media to influence or to promote indigenous communities' culture and indigenous communities' tradition in world. And here is status of community radios in Bangladesh. There are 17 community radios in Bangladesh broadcasting around 125 years programs per day. Nearly 1,000 young youth and women are involved in this kind of community radio. And approximate audience number is 5.6 million. This is according to BNNRC, which is prominent in Bangladesh and who has been working with community radios in Bangladesh. And now there are 4 community radios in northwestern part of Bangladesh. These are Radio Podda, Radio Mohananda, Radio Borendro, and Radio Mukti. These are 4 in northwestern districts in Bangladesh. And here is some information about Radio Podda. Radio Podda is initiated by CCD Bangladesh, which is a non-government organization in northwestern part, and they provided, this is the first time they provided aid in Bangladesh to indigenous 25 community people who were students then, and they trained them for 1 month and for radio journalism, and then they worked for several programs in Radio Podda. It is important that the training was conducted in association with UNESCO, and there is one of the major outcome of this study that at most of the time the community radios has been working with it, have been working with it in association with some development partners, and they face several challenges when that development partners withdraw their funds or this kind of grants. Here is the objective of my study. I wanted to analyze the trends of coverage on indigenous issues in community radio to identify the use of media trends in local indigenous community to assess as knowledge of indigenous people about community radio, to assess indigenous people's participation in programs and policy in Radio Podda, to unveil expectations and effects of community radio among local indigenous peoples. Methodology, it was basically a qualitative study, and I analyzed a content which was very prominent for Radio Podda, that was Shekore Shondhane, Shekhar Sandhane, that means behind the root. This was firstly introduced by Radio Podda in first time in Bangladesh at the arena of community radio, and that was a 30 minutes program produced by that 25 trained community indigenous peoples. They were actively participated on the event, and I analyzed 32 series of Shekhar Sandhane and broadcasted every Monday 7:30 p.m. while concluded. That means that was a 30 minutes program, weekly program, and that highlights on local government success, local success, problems and possibilities, movement, rights of indigenous peoples, indigenous community development, institutions, dress, celebration, etc. There was a link of 1.5 minutes in every series. Likely, you can say this is Bangla writing. That means Jati Boichitro Bangladesher Ahongkar. Okay, here was some sounds of and background music of the event, which was at the first leading options of Shekhar Sandhane. Unfortunately, that was not okay. And that was the background music was nice because there was background music of some songs. All the 32 series of Shekhar Sandhane, the introduction of the Shekhar Sandhane was always same in every week. That was, I think, that was boring, but that was not boring due to the background music. Contents of Shekhar Sandhane, it describes detail about Garo, Chakma, Tuli, Mushiar. This contents always consists of several indigenous communities in Bangladesh, about their dresses, about their culture, about their or several issues like rights to study indigenous language, reflection and promotion of their culture in media, grabbing of residential areas, human rights, early marriage, establishment of Shohid Mina, recognizing indigenous martyred in 1971. We know that in 1971 there was a war between Bangladesh and Pakistan, and then some indigenous people were died, and that recognized two indigenous peoples. There was established a Shohid Minar, and that program was on Shohid Minar, and 30 minutes long program. There were some relevant interviews along with side the indigenous communities in the event, like lawmakers or like member of parliaments, like civil society people, and some presentations of 30 minutes program, and the program was first time media event with the performance of indigenous community, which I told you earlier, and there was two announcers. There is another statistics here. At the first time, the program was conducted by only one producer, but after 10 series, that was conducted by two or three producers because of making a difference. And I conducted 50 indigenous peoples in Bangladesh, in my area, from two villages of two thanas, I collected some data about about the attitudes, their attitudes regarding community radios in Bangladesh, about their likings and dislikings, the impacts of community radios in these 4 or 5 years, like this. And we can see they are just mistaken some words, like the top of the bottom, there was is that means 15 to 25, 32, 25 to 40, there were 10 and 40 to 55 years, there were are 8. Below SSC, there were 35, SSC pass 10 and graduate 5. And there were male 40 and female in 10. And and these are my or characteristics of my respondents, why I hear are male more than female. There is a common idea in Bangladesh that due to educational and socio perspective background, most of the female indigenous people don't want to talk with unfamiliar or don't want to talk more in several issues who's then male. And understanding of mass media, they understood radio and television. 32 of the 50 understood radio and television as mass media, and radio, TV and newspaper, 18 of my respondents as told radio, TV and newspaper as mass media. And use of media, they 13 people used only radio, and 30 used radio and TV, and 7 and newspaper. Causes of using mass media, I wanted to gather some information regarding this. Most of the respondents prefer Radio Podda, Bangladesh Betar, and Radio Furti. Bangladesh Betar is owned by the government of Bangladesh, and Radio Furti, it is an FM radio by business owners. And 25 of 50 respondents, that means 50% respondents, and confess that they listen for entertainment, while 18 use radio for getting information. 3 of the respondents use radio for education, whereas 4 for getting right direction. That means they listen radio for 4 reasons measured. And preference, 15 respondents prefer news, while 30 respondents enjoy song like Gombhira. Gombhira is a local song and cinema song. And 50 especially like most BBC radio. BBC news, exactly. Okay, and then most of the indigenous community people, my respondents were asked about what's their what's the effects of community radio Podda on their everyday life. They told us like that for our refreshment they use this, and everyday survival for surviving in everyday life, like from save their children from diarrhea, from save their children from that means several diseases, and for their cultivation process as to survive within the disaster. That means adaptation, and within the disaster they gathered several knowledge from this community radio. Community radio and indigenous people knowledge about there is knowledge about community radio. They were asked about what do you feel about community radio. They don't told us theoretically, but they 10 of the respondents asked us that they do not make any difference between the community radio and traditional radio, but at 14 of them confessed us that they differentiated community radio and other radio or other traditional media. And listening time, most of them listen, there were 30 respondents listen radio at evening, and 15 in at morning, and 5 at when they get time they listen radio. Evaluation of Shekore Shondhane, as that program was produced by indigenous community people in 2012. Most of them were not familiar with the program. Language and schedule of Radio Podda, they don't have any complaint regarding the language or time schedule. Indigenous issue coverage, and only 8 confess that there is no any problem, or they seen as moderate level the role of community radio on indigenous issues at moderate, but 42 who do not say it like this. They just expected minimum 1 hour program on indigenous issues every day to promote their language, their culture, their heritage. The respondents also requested for several items of programs, like you can see a magazine on early marriage, live on annual events, transformation of religion, discrimination on human rights, protection of language, education and career, survival challenges due to climate change, less wages among the indigenous community people in Bangladesh. These were their expectations, indigenous people participation in programs and management. And I surveyed 50 people, that means 50 indigenous respondents, but only one of the respondents were involved in a program. His interview was published or broadcasted by Community Radio Podda, and he knows some people who are involved in Community Radio, but 49 people, they didn't get any chance to communicate with Radio Podda. They didn't take part in management and in Radio Podda. This is another, and effects, I told about effects of this, and there is some recommendations, and more programs on community participation. There is some lack of community participation in community radios. More local community participation in management of radio. There is highlighted in local, because when I asked to the management of Radio Podda why that 25 community people, indigenous community people left your organization, they told us that due to their academic background, they were from several districts of Rajshahi region, but there was no anyone who was from that Rajshahi district. That means they were not local, and due to end of their study, they went to several organizations for their job. Need minimum 1 hour magazine on indigenous issues to promote their lives, culture, language, tradition, folk knowledge, entertainment, history, etc. I just wanted to tell here dependency on grants or dependency on financial grant from several development partners. This is one kind of disease for community radios in Bangladesh, because when community radios in Bangladesh launched, they assured government to promote local voiceless, but at now Bangladesh, most of the community radio are surviving with that support. When they end their support, they do not provide any more voices or any more events in those community radios. These are lackings for community radios in Bangladesh, as well as this is a major challenge for community radios in Bangladesh. I think incentive is very necessary for community participation or community people like this. And this is my last slide. This is thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.